Kenya Coastal Development Project, KCDP, is a multi-sectoral development project financed by the World Bank, the Global Environment Facility, and the Government of Kenya in the Ministry of Agriculture, Livestock and Fisheries. The project, whose development objective is to improve management effectiveness and enhance revenue generation of Kenya's coastal and marine resources, is hosted by the Kenya Marine and Fisheries Research Institute, KEMFRI, and implemented by 7 government agencies. The project is structured in 4 components. 1. Fisheries resources, which deals with sustainable management of fisheries resources. 2. Natural resources, dealing with sound management of natural resources. 3. Alternative livelihoods, dealing with support for alternative livelihoods. And 4. Component 4, which deals with capacity building, monitoring and evaluation system, project management, communication and CVF or HMP, Hazina ya Maendeleo ya Pwani, a Swahili word translation of Community Village Fund. Through Component 4, KCDP targets to build the capacity of coastal communities in the management of natural resources, as well as ensure effective delivery of the project through training of its own staff. In achieving this goal, the component uses various approaches, which include supporting coastal students to undertake master's and undergraduate degrees, as well as craft courses at certificate level. Through these approaches, a number of coastal students have been supported. Master's degree, KCDP staff, 34 students. Master's degree, coastal students, 40 students. Undergraduate degree, coastal students, 29 students. Certificate courses, KWSTI, coastal students, 30 students, and internships, 21 students, in total 206 students. It is in this framework that KCDP also planned to support additional 60 coastal students to undertake certificate courses in forestry at the Kenya Forestry College, KFC, in Londiani. Kenya Forestry College is located in Londiani within the Rift Valley of Kenya and offers a variety of skilled courses in forestry management. Among these is a 2-year certificate course in forestry that is tailored for field technicians. KFC has a well-established infrastructure and staff capacity able to accommodate over 200 students for practical field experience in classes and hostels. Other reasons of selecting KFC for certificate course include: Kenya Forestry College is affiliated to Kenya Forestry Service, KFS, and works closely with the Kenya Forestry Research Institute, KEFRI, which is one of KCDP implementing partner. Willingness of KFC in tailor-making the certificate course in forestry to fit within the KCDP financial support. And the KCDP scholarship at KFC has a comprise towards practical training, which resonates well with the objective of the capacity building approach of KCDP. Financial support. KCDP scholarship for each student will comprise tuition cost, statutory fees, and a modest monthly living stipend, all valued at approximately 310,500 Kenya shillings. Need for financial support was a maximum of 5 points to be awarded for submission of chief's letter and any additional supporting document indicating need for financial support. Selection process. Given the large number of applications, a 2-level selection criteria was used to shortlist and identify successful candidates. The initial shortlisting was done by selecting students who had a mean grade of D+ aggregate at secondary school level with the following subject-specific scores: C- in biological sciences, C- in languages, and D+ in mathematics. The final selection was done by ranking the students on the basis of a cumulative score where grades obtained in science subjects, especially maths, languages, and biological sciences were the key focus. Special consideration was, however, made for students coming from indigenous communities as well as marginalized regions of the coastal counties. Scholarship duration. The intended scholarship duration for the certificate course shall be for a maximum of 18 months. At the end of the training period, the student shall be required to demonstrate completion of coursework and shall graduate as per the KFC requirements. To actualize the scholarship for certificate in forestry, the Component 4 team, in consultation with KFC, put a call for application in local dailies, KCDP website, radios, and county offices within the month of January 2015 for an intake in February 2015. A total of 400 applications were received and evaluated by the Capacity Building Committee, CBC, of KCDP with the support of KFC. On this basis, a total of 57 candidates were selected for the award of the KCDP scholarship to undertake a certificate course in forestry. On Thursday, the 19th March 2015, the students were visited by the capacity building team from Mombasa for briefing. The team members comprised Dr. Melchizedek Osore, the KCDP Component 4 manager, Ms. Farida Hassan, manager, Hazina ya Maendeleo ya Pwani.
We are looking for A students in our counties so that tunajua tukiwajenga hao then Pwani
Mr. George Morara, County Liaison Manager. Professor Paul Guyo, Capacity Building Committee Member, Pwani University.
But I want you as a class, ukitoka hapo ukisikia ile power swap, una feel the same pain ambayo mtu mmoja anakata. Mtu sio mti.
And Dr. Josiah Odalo, Capacity Building Committee Member, Technical University of Mombasa.
I know you are good students.
The objective of the visit was to meet the scholarship awardees and discuss, among others, the following key issues. 1. Emphasis on the objective of the KCDP Capacity Building Initiative. 2. Highlight the expectation of KCDP on the scholarship awardees. And 3. Advise the students on the need to maintain high levels of integrity, discipline, and academic performance.
Tulipoingia hapa mara kwanza tulikuwa na uoga mwingi. Tumekuja tukakutana na wanafunzi ambao walikuwa wametutangulia hapa kwa kipindi kuanzia mnamo wa January. Tumekuja hapa wakawa wanatupatia vidokezo vingi kusema kwamba sheria za makozi zilivyoregelewa. Pass mark ilipandishwa kutoka 41% to 45%. Sasa sisi tulikuwa na lile dukuduku uoga. Genetu walivyotutembelea siku ya leo wametupatia wasia mzuri, wakatupatia mawazo mazuri, wakatuguide. Hata sisi watu kama sisi wa Pwani kule ambao tulikuwa tumelingana na vile tumekuwa tukipitia masomo yetu, tumeambiwa eneo letu la kule Taita Taveta County lilikuwa ndio almost eneo la mwisho humu nchini, kwa sababu naambiwa 80% kwa eneo letu la Taita Taveta County ni jangwa. Kwa hivyo 20% ambayo imebaki ndio imebaki green spaces. Kwa hivyo sasa mimi binafsi na wale wenzangu kutoka eneo la Taita Taveta tumeahidi kwamba tutaenda kuweka bidii, tutajibidisha kwenye masomo yetu, na sietia masomo tu tunasoma kwa ajili ya kupita tuajiriwe kazi tu peke yake. Hapana, sisi wenyewe tumejitolea kwa udi na uvumba kwamba tutaenda kufanya bidii hata kama hatutaajiriwa, lakini sisi wenyewe tutaenda kuanzisha miradi yetu huko nje na tutaenda kuhimiza jamii jinsi ya kutunza misitu, na pia sisi tutaanzisha na safari zetu sisi wenyewe ili tuhamasishe jamii kupanda miti hiyo, kuimarisha mazingira huko pia.